What's up, everybody? This is Jay, and this video is about what is the actual timeline for Power. A lot of people are saying that this show has taken place in the matter of just 5 or 6 months based off of some interview Courtney Kemp did on AfterBuzz. Well, I got a little clip of that. Let's listen to it, and I'm going to break it down.
And speaking of that, what is actually, what's the age range? Because, you know,
I'm just saying to you, it's very difficult because your kids on a series, they grow, even if the time doesn't grow.
Right.
So we're playing Tariq as 15 right now, but that is really not, I mean, if you were really counting the days, the series itself has been 5 months, but we cannot play Michael Rainey as 12.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, first of all, she said right now he's playing at 15. This interview was for season 5. So right now in season 5, he's 15. But when the original show started, they were in 5th grade. He and Rainer play twins. Is that correct? They're supposed to be twins. I will prove that they were in 5th grade in season 1, and we'll see what happens. But it's no way in the world that all of this entirety of the show has taken place in a span.
It just doesn't make sense visually. And because it's only 10 episodes and we're a year in between September to September shooting, we've allowed the audiences...
Okay, you're damn right it doesn't make sense visually. The boy is big as hell. He's bigger than Ghost. He started off smaller than Midge, shorter than Tasha. Now he's just as big as Ghost. And you're going to tell me that he's in 5th grade? That means he's 10 years old. He ain't no 10 years old unless he's baby Shaq, okay? So let's see what else.
The audience's experience of this time is that it's been 5 years.
Yeah.
That's not accurate to what is taking place within the narrative, but we just have to kind of live with it because that kid is taller than me. What am I going to do?
Yeah.
Exactly. Our experience is 5 years. You didn't originally want to do that, but you have to live with it, which means that you didn't want to, but you accept it because it wouldn't make sense if you went against it, because the audience would abandon the show because it wouldn't be realistic. It wouldn't make sense. And you can't expect people to watch a show that's supposed to be grounded in realism and it's flawed from the start because you got somebody that's big as Shaq talking about he's in 5th grade, killing people, selling drugs, getting high, having sex in 5th grade. Get out of here.
You know, he's not in 6th grade.
Yeah.
She says 6th grade. He's not in 6th grade. Remember, this interview is during season 5. People, context matters. Okay? This isn't her speaking on the entirety of the show as, you know, the show was completed or from the beginning. She's speaking in the moment, in season 5, right this moment. Okay? He's 15. He wasn't 15 when the show started. What was he? Webster? Look at this. More proof.
You do what I said. Good morning, sleepyhead.
Morning.
I didn't hear you come in last night.
Yeah, the count was off, so we stayed to make sure it was right. And then y'all woke me up with those beautiful voices you keep singing like that. Guarantee you get to leave.
A 5th grader's never getting.
Yeah, but baby girl, they never seen a 5th grader like my Raina St. Patrick.
Oh, 5th graders never get the lead, but baby girl, we ain't never seen a 5th grader like my Raina. Oh, so she's in 5th grade in season 1. Oh, and her and Tariq are twins. Oh, so how in the hell is he 15, but in 5th grade? What is he, Benjamin Button in reverse? I don't get it. So anybody that believes that, you haven't been paying attention to the show. The show speaks for itself. Let the show speak for itself. Now, he's came a long way for a 5th grader. These are the biggest 5th graders in history of school. Look at this big ass white boy. He's in 5th grade. He looked like he's getting ready to try out for the Chicago Bears next week. What is he? Kevin Love Jr.? And then now Tariq, after just spending a little time with Kanan, is ready to be all gangster. What do you go to gangster boot camp? Now he's yoking them up, punking them out, making them flinch, and he got all of this. And how long? So he learned all of this from Kanan in 1 week's time period, right? I mean, if you packing this whole show in the 5 months, he hasn't had enough time to be hard and learn anything. He's just not learning. So it doesn't make sense. He spent months with Kanan hanging out. Okay? That's what would be more realistic. Yeah, he first spent a lot of time with him as Slim.
And so how old is Tasha and Ghost with around
this
their
is
age?
The age.
Tasha turned 30 in episode 106.
Season 1, she turned 30.
Yeah. Ghost was always 35. Mm-hmm. Tommy's 35. Angelo's 35. 34, 35 in there.
If she got pregnant at 15 by Ghost, Ghost is a pedophile, people. We're watching R. Kelly Jr. in action. That's not right. He's not a pedophile. Not even made us root for a pedophile, drug dealer, slash R. Kelly wannabe. What's really going on, folks? Tell me, please.
I was always the thing. Obviously, now, we're 5 years later. For the actors. Yeah. But that doesn't mean that the ages of the...
That's true. And you could get away with that if you didn't have them going to jail. Okay, and so much things happening in serious jail cases that would take months to get unraveled. Okay, and then you put kids in the mix. So how can you say that it's only been 5 months when we are watching these kids grow? And now they went from innocent little kids to now gangster, shooting people, on drugs, having sex, and one is dying. We know a little bobblehead baby was a baby, and now she's walking around talking now. She's at least 5 or 6 years old. Why put them in the show? So you see in this window, in any big city, you have to pay a tax. And that sticker that says 1114 means that it expires in November of 2014. The show started in 2014. The year of the show in season one is 2014. Okay? That's important. We know that the show is 2014. That's what that 14 means. They're not doing a time lapse. They're not saying that this is, you know, 10 years ago. This is supposed to be happening in current time. Look at Tasha's window. It says 2016, September. That's 2 years later, okay? And how did Tommy meet Polly, have time to go out with her, even though she played hard to get, fall in love, then they break up, she leaves out of town, Ghost makes her leave, come back in town after being gone for a while, and then next thing you know, they're all in love again. Then he kills her in what, a month, a week? It makes no sense. When Angie went back to work and she was trying to get in contact with Ghost, but his number was disconnected, she looked him up on the computer. Okay, that's a fake name. We know his name is Omari Hardwick, not James St. Patrick. Why would they make his birthday 1974? Huh? How in the hell is he 35 years old if his birthday is in 1974 and this is the year 2014? We could do the math real simple. In 74, he was born. 84, he was 10. 94, 20. 2004, 30. 2014, he was 40 years old, okay? Where's 35 coming from? Is it 2009? No, it's 2014. And Angie said they met, it's been 18 years. That means that he was 35. Then if you subtract, then they were 17. That's the only way you could think it's been 18 years and they was 35, but it doesn't make sense.
The court finds that no combination of conditions can assure the defendant's appearance for trial. Therefore, bail is denied. Defendant is remanded to custody to await trial. Trial date is set for the 23rd at 9 a.m.
So Tommy's got breasted with Lobos with the money, gone to jail. They're telling the trial date is set for the 23rd, which is obviously at least a week or two from when he was already in court. And all of this is going to happen and take place in how long? It does not make sense. It's physically impossible. It is impossible that he can get arrested with a known notorious drug dealer, have all of his court cases, get bail denied, have his stuff come back, and next thing you know, he's out on bail, and all of this took place in the U.S. court system in New York in 1 week or 1 month. It's ridiculous. Now we have Kanan. How in the world did this dude spend time in jail, get out of jail, then make it to find out all this information about Ghost and Tommy through Tommy. Then him and Ghost end up fighting. Then Ghost beats his ass, burns him like barbecue broke legs, roasted his arm like it was a rack of lamb. This dude is crispily craggly coon all over the place. He's over here burnt to the pink meat, okay? And he's sitting here half roasted like an almond inside a jukebox bed. Then she gets him out of the hospital. He makes it to DC, heals. This dude heals from damn near second, third degree burns with no problem. What is he, half Wolverine? This makes no damn sense, okay? So he heals, makes it back, becomes friends, enemies, friends again with Dre, fighting people, Crystal's balls, all of this happens, ends up getting killed, reconnecting with Tariq, all of this storyline in a week.
Wait, what?
Come
on. Y'all knows who told her what happened?
Who cares, you? I told him this day, motherfucker slamming against my car.
Ghost. This dude goes to jail for murder of Greg Knox, a federal agent. Proctor and Waterhead Terry figure this case out, pass it in Matlock, okay? They figure out all of this information, get this man off of facing the death penalty, okay? All of this different things going on, the ins and outs of this case. And how long did this take place? Talk to me, people. Please, let me know. How in the hell did they do this? Proctor is better than Johnny Cochran. It's Johnny Proctor up in this piece. How did they do this? It's impossible. If you expect me to believe this, I have... Tell me anything, please. Just don't expect me to believe it. I mean, you might as well tell me you got the Millennium Falcon parked outside.
He did it. And his kids are collateral damage. Not our concern. We're going for the wedding.
So, wait a minute. So... Ghost meets Angie, they reconnect, fall in love, move in together, have all this stuff going on, break up, then they back together, then they not, then Greg gets killed, and now they saying did he do it or not, and now she's convinced he's a murderer? She sure can flip slides like water slides and change her emotions and everything, because how could you know this for a fact and be ready to put this man in jail and then find the evidence, change your mind, sacrifice your career, get him off? Come on, man. This just doesn't make sense. Then, Teresi. How did Teresi figure out that this was Ghost? And then extort him. I don't get it. He's gotta be the best mobster that ever lived. How did he figure it all out? Huh?
Wrong guy. Then you won't mind if I go to that same
that ain't him.
Mark, what do you think he's gonna do if I go to him and tell him I got proof?
But I don't know how he gonna believe that he got proof of who he is and make these people believe and make Ghost think that he has proof of who he is. Him and Ghost kill Charlie Murphy. And listen to this.
Now what's it gonna be?
So he said 20,000 and every week after that. How can it be going on for weeks? How could he be in jail and making this arrangement for a week time frame like this when he's only gonna be there for what, 2 weeks minimum? This man was in jail for at least a couple months. Tasha even said she ran out of cash. That's why she borrowed money from Simon Stern. She didn't have enough legit money to pay for bills and things. If he was only in there for less than a month, people only pay bills once a month. How can you go broke and run out of money if he was only in jail for a month at most? It makes no damn sense, people. And if you believe that all of this show took place in just 5 months, you're nuts.
Yo, my dad's making me go to Connecticut for school. People are busy as fuck up there. you got any more of this so I can take it up there?
Yeah.
So now he's talking about going to Connecticut for school. What school was that? Choke. The same school that Angie went to. They don't take fifth graders. That was a prep school. At best, they taking high school students. Okay? He's in high school. And then he's talking about, you got any more of this? He wasn't talking about Kool-Aid. This boy is sipping lean, scissor lean, okay? More lean than Pimp C. He ain't addicted to lean in fifth grade. That don't make no damn sense. That's the stupidest thing I ever heard in my life. And you ain't hanging with no girl and sitting in her house alone when you're in fifth grade.
But maybe I could if you moved in the city before you go.
You could come to my school dance.
So he said, come to my school dance. What school has a dance for fifth graders? Please let me know. Especially where you inviting girls to come dance with you when you in fifth grade. That's nothing I ever had an experience with. Maybe I'm just, you know, behind the times. But most people are not inviting girls to a school dance in fifth grade to hang out. Most girls hang with girls. Most boys hang with boys when they in fifth grade. They're not looking to hang with each other and have a relationship. And if it was, it would be puppy love. They are having a little more than puppy love. And she's going to explain and pretty much prove my point that they doing a little more than kiss in the shower or on the side. They doing a little more than that. And let's hear what she has to say. Because if you think that they in fifth grade, look at her. She the thickest, most grownest fifth grader ever saw.
I have to think about lean, you know, think of something else.
Ooh, so she could say we could have lean and we could do something else. What is something else they gonna do? Play with Legos? I mean, look at this girl. She got more body than a pickup. I mean, what is you talking about? She ain't no little girl. This girl is full. She is not no little kid in fifth grade wearing a training bra, okay? She got more body than some grown women. This girl is thicker than all outdoors. She ain't no kid. And look at that smile on his face. He ain't smiling because he looking forward to playing Uno, all right? He about to play Duo. That's what they about to be playing. He ready to play Hide the Hot Dog. That's what he was looking forward to doing, okay? Look at her smiling. That they ain't laughing for that. And when she put her head on his back, that made his wee-wee hard. And look at this. Now all of a sudden, Tasha want to go clean. Okay? Talking about some, I want to go clean. Just because she dating Mr. Clean. So you mean to tell me, in the first episode, Ghost want to go clean. He want more. And she said, what more? We have it all. And then in a matter of a couple months, she's came to an epiphany because of Waterhead Terry leaking all over the place that she wants to go clean now. This makes no damn sense at all. It's unbelievable. And for her to have that much of a turnaround and who she is just ridiculous. Nobody changes their mind that fast when you were that set on one way.
For real, completely. From now on, any business that we do together, it'll be legit. I promise. Now I got a question for you. Why are you gonna tell me about you and Tom? You know. Yeah, I know. I figured that shit out. I ain't stupid. And Tommy admitted it.
So wait a minute. So her and Tommy got into a relationship after he was with Holly. After Holly was with him for all this amount of time, however long you want to say, and end up dead. Now she's with Holly, with Tommy, and now she's to the point where she got emotionally involved, and then they broke it off, and now she's hurt. From a week or two relationship, you don't get emotionally involved with being with somebody for a week or two, or a month. The way that she's looking, she was emotionally attached because she was with Tommy for a while, at least a few months. Okay? That just doesn't make any sense.
Is it true?
What?
Is it true? You're mouthing a war against the internet again. I didn't get into the drug game for the violence. Man, the cloth, for Christ's sake. Sorry, Tommy, but I'm out.
You tried to stop me, man.
Them?
Yeah, they're all out.
So wait a minute. Tommy is at war with the Jimenez again. So they've already had a beef, calmed it down, about to have another beef. Dre, it went from a corner boy to working his way up with Kanan, to working his way up with Ghost, to working his way in with Tommy, taking out Julio, and now taking over Tommy's whole organization. And what? A month and a half? Get the hell out of here. I do not buy this. I won't buy that for a dollar. Don't ever come to me with this crap. This took time. This is a process that Dre had to take his time to go through. Okay? Look at this crap here. So, Tasha is all over Terry. And Terry all over Tasha. She rubbing all on that waterhead, enjoying Waterworld. And they just met. Now, they ain't been together long, but they've been back and forth dealing with each other because Ghost was in jail for a while. They got to know each other for a few months at least. Then they went to the little club, fake ass karaoke, doing whatever they did. Then they started messing around and sleeping around or whatever. Then remember, Terry dipped on her and went Ghost and left out of town. What, he left out of town and came back in the same week? It don't make sense. This show is impossible to have taken place in a 5-month time frame. Courtney Kemp is a creator of the show, one of the writers, head writers, or at least initially. A lot of times when people are in a show, they have ideas and a direction for the show. But the minute details and everything, they do not handle it. She does not write every episode. She does not direct the episodes. It's different directors on TV shows. Different things happen. A lot of people don't even watch the show after they make it. When I would be watching interviews and things, actors, and they'd say, "Oh, well, what did you think of the movie?" "Oh, I didn't watch it." People would say, "How did you not watch it?" I used to think, how do they not watch that? Now that I make my little bit of creative, you know, property and videos, I understand. You spend so much time writing, creating, editing behind the camera, in front of the camera. You don't really watch the videos and you don't watch the material when it's over. You lived it. You've done that. And when you're in a TV show, you have even more people behind the scenes doing things. You may watch the premiere, you may watch this, you may watch that, but you don't sit and watch everything like a fan does. The show speaks for itself. Let the show, let the screen speak for itself. Courtney Kemp, I'm not saying she's a liar. I just think that she is confused. She doesn't realize that a lot of her original ideas didn't take place. It didn't happen, okay? And so that doesn't mean you go on shows and spoil it and confuse your fans. You have all this information. Who created that ID? Who put his birth date in 1974? Huh? They should have put it at a different date. Okay? Who's the ones that's got these people driving around in cars with the years on it? Who's the one that used child actors and then we watch them grow up? They're in fifth grade, now they're in high school. It doesn't make sense. So, anyway, enough with all of that. I hope I laid it out for you guys to see. I hope you understand. And if you still don't get it, I don't know. There's nothing else I can do for you. The video was already going to be very long. I had to shorten it to make it just, you know, compact for people to digest. So, I hope you was able to digest that. And if not, hey, spit it up and move on because it ain't for you. I want to thank everybody to support me at patreon.com where my true fans are. I try to get everything out to you first. I also appreciate all the help and support that you have given me to help my channel grow. please join me at patreon.com. The link is below. If you want to see this entire interview and break it down yourself, I'm going to put the link to this video with the AfterBuzz and Courtney Kemp. It's going to be in the description below. So if you want to watch that video and watch what they had to say, take your time, check it out. Then you'll see for yourself what she meant, what you thought she meant, and you can understand, and maybe you get it, maybe you don't, whatever the case. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, and I'll holla at you. And also, last but not least,
for watching,
and please subscribe,
and
don't
forget to
thank
red
bell
and
smash
that
like button,
and
I'll see
you
in the
next video.
Peace.